Hi there, hello, salutations, I'm back. Do you like bicycles? So, this video is going to be a little different from previous ones, in that, well, I want to make something that, works. I know you're all sitting there waiting to see how this all goes horribly wrong, and look, schadenfreude is a wonderful thing, but I'm actually trying this time, so hopefully this does better than hovercraft. Anyways, now this is a story about how my life got flipped, turned upside down, and I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there, and I'll tell you how I built an e-bike in my basement. So without, you know, doxing myself, here's a map of my route to work. It's around 20 or 30 kilometers each way and involves crossing a big brown bridge. The biggest bike-related problem is that the area is very mountainy and I am very built like a wet noodly. So my solution is to strap a big-ass motor on the back of the bike so I can just kinda cheat it when going uphill. I have to start somewhere, so naturally I'm starting with this 10-ish-year-old giant rapid. Not a giant bicycle, but a giant bicycle. I'm sure that's the first time anyone's ever made that joke. It's noted for being excellent for fitness, although I have no clue what that's supposed to mean. But it's very lightweight and nimble, which are characteristics that I'm sure won't be affected at all by the roughly 15 kilos of battery and motor that I am adding. Anyways, I chose this bike because I found it lying under my parents' deck and was told I could use it in exchange for removing the remains of my hovercraft. Good riddance. So, in order to get this bicycle ready to whisk me off to work, we're going to go shopping for one e-bike conversion kit, one replacement rear tire to replace the one that had become so worn down, it's basically slick. Look at the tires, look at that. I don't look good. Look at the tires, look at that. That don't look good, does it? You wouldn't want to ride on that in the rain, would ya? Would ya? A 48-volt battery. A new rust-free chain, new pedals that don't suck, also rust-free and without the clippy clips. One front light for, seeing. A bar and mirror for also seeing. Cable sleeving so that it can, look all nice. Some zip ties. The cheapest heat gun I could find, which definitely is not a fire hazard. Some heat shrink tubing for that heat gun. XT60 connectors for the battery. A set of WERA Allen keys because like they're really nice and I can't recommend these enough. Like seriously, just buy good Allen keys. They're nice. It's worth $50 for Allen keys. A tail light because my tail is afraid of the dark. A Pannier bag, just the one, so that my weight distribution is on hard mode. A rear rack for storing random crap! A fancy helmet with, like, Bluetooth and a dash cam and lights and stuff so that I don't get run over, I guess. And all that crap is gonna get stuck on the bike that's over there out of frame. And you can see what I built with it! Say now, Petronella.
So that's my bike.
It's very bikey. You might be asking yourself a couple of questions. One, Noah, why are you holding the microphone? Like as if it's the skull from Hamlet. To that I say, I'm just going to roll with it. Number two, why do you have your bike behind you on a green sheet? Which you're not asking, because to you it's a flawless green screen. Yeah. Anyways, I absolutely love it. It can go fast and sort of keep up with cars. Hills are much less of an issue. And the visibility. Oh, the visibility. Oh. I didn't realize how bad the blind spots in a car were until I rode this thing to work a couple times. Like, seriously, it's incredible. Not once did I think about whether I was going to cut someone off, where my wheels were, how far away the front of my bike was, are there pedestrians there, who's beside me, who's behind me, am I turning, all those things. You just know. You just know because it's in your peripheral vision. I mean, it's absolutely incredible. It's kind of common sense, because just wherever I fit, the bike will fit, but still, I'm weirdly amazed by it, and I really, really love that. So I clearly think it's pretty great and really awesome, but the question is it objectively better than driving a car? And while it's better for the environment, and I have more fun with it, the main question that you might be asking yourself is it faster? So the car did it in under 30 minutes, but how fast was the fastest time on the bike? Well, my fastest time was 43 minutes, which is slower by about 50%, but that's okay. You see, for some trips, for example to the local coffee shop and back, the bike is indeed quite a lot faster. And for some trips, it is quite a bit slower. The thing is, I live quite close to a highway, and my work is also quite close to the same highway, so it is quite a bit artificially faster to drive. See, I was trying to not cherry pick by using my actual house and actual work, but I inadvertently seem to have cherry picked something in the opposite direction that was much easier to drive than it is to bike. If I was commuting downtown, for example, the bike would win hands down, thanks to traffic, not having highways, and you know, actual infrastructure and all sorts of things. But I also just really enjoy biking. You see, so far I've put over 520 kilometers onto my bike's odometer. That's like biking from Ottawa to London, Ontario. Essentially what I'm trying to say is I cannot imagine that there is a better vehicle out there than an e-bike. It's so much fun to ride, and it feels like I'm actually engaging with the city as I travel instead of just sitting in a sad little metal box the whole way. It's nimble, fast, cheap, incredibly eco-friendly. It flattens hills like an overzealous landscaper, and if I run out of battery, I still have a mode of transportation. Try that with a car, e-scooter, motorbike, whatever else. You get the idea. This whole upgrade cost me around 1,500 to 2,000 Canadian tire monies, but you could easily find a new e-bike for that price if you aren't so picky about the spec. Hell, you can get a cargo e-bike and haul loads of stuff for around 2,000 gun-toting Freedom Bald Eagle dollars. And pay nothing in gas. Nothing. No gas, no insurance, no loans, cheaper maintenance, a lower price from the get-go, and all the practicality of a family car. I mean, sure, you could buy a car for the price of this bike. It's possible. But it's gonna be this 2002 Hyundai Elantra, and you still gotta pay for gas and insurance and maintenance on a 20-something-year-old car. It's got 275,000 kilometers on it! Sorry, I didn't mean for this video to become a massive rant slash commercial for e-bikes, but alas it has. If you're at all interested in this sort of stuff and are still watching, I'll put a link to everything I bought in the video description. I can't recommend it enough, and I am not being paid to say that. If you aren't the maker type, I also highly recommend Rad Power Bikes. My girlfriend bought one after trying this guy out. Made some nice bikes for affordable prices, especially geared towards those who wouldn't ordinarily be cyclists. Again, no money has changed hands here, I just feel very strongly about this. And that's the video. For all of you hoping to see me fail, I am so sorry to disappoint, but after like 50 videos, I finally figured out how to make something that works! If you still need to get that schadenfreude out of your system though, I can recommend to you the elevator video, or maybe the cookie dunking arm. And subscribe if for some strange reason you feel the need to be reminded of my presence in like 3 months' time.